Hey YouTube, Cyclonius here. Welcome to another video. Happy Mother's Day to all the YouTube mothers that are out there. May you live many, many more years of happiness. With that being said, on with the video. So there's a video going out and about on social media and YouTube where you have a mixed martial artist going up against a Tai Chi Master. Both are Chinese, and the match itself looks like it occurred over in China. It has caused a stir in China because the mixed martial arts guy basically demolished the Tai Chi Master. And it's causing a discussion amongst Chinese because, again, China is renowned for its martial arts. And here comes mixed martial arts, demolishes a guy who's supposedly a master of Tai Chi, and it's caused a lot of people to basically reflect on whether, hey, is our martial arts adapted, or can it be adapted to modern day contests and fighting? Again, it's not to say in any way that the Tai Chi guy doesn't know Tai Chi, or that Tai Chi is bad and you shouldn't use it. Because it's in my opinion that it's not the martial arts that makes the person. It's the person that applies the martial art properly that makes the martial art. Well, okay, so the fight itself. The fight itself, introductions, they shake hands. The MMA guy, again, gets his fighting stance, and he's ready to go. Full of testosterone, full of energy, he's ready to go. The Tai Chi guy, on the other hand, is like this. And, again, they probe each other. Finally, the mixed martial arts guy goes in for the kill. The Tai Chi guy goes on the floor, and the MMA guys just pounding him, and the fight stops. They stop the fight. The fight probably lasted no more than 15 seconds or so. It's quite an amazing fight to see. Not because of the guy getting demolished, but because of the tactics used by the MMA guy. Now, he basically probed the Tai Chi guy. He probed him, and then seeing that, okay, he's not going to do anything, he just waiting for the kill. And the rest is history. But the question becomes, why did the Tai Chi guy lose? Why? And I think the answer is because of failure to adapt. Failure to understand modern day context of fighting. And I'm pretty sure that the Tai Chi master has not sparred in a while. Going back to the first reason, adaptability. The Tai Chi guy did not adapt to the MMA guy, not understanding what MMA is. It was obvious that the Tai Chi guy was very underprepared. It was obvious he did not know what to expect from an MMA guy. So as the MMA guys come in, the Tai Chi guy is just flailing his arms and then finally collapsing on the floor and covering up. That was his first mistake, not adapting. In a modern day context, don't get me wrong, martial arts does have its use, but it's on you, the martial artist, to adapt. Remember, in class, for example, in my class, American Kempo, they say, okay, right step to punch. So, okay, boom, right step to punch. Now, we stand there, yes, so the guy can do his technique. But you and I know that when we throw that punch, that arm is not going to be there. So you have to act fast. It's not like the movies. It's not like a Yip Man movie where you see a Fong Sao, a Tan Sao, a Gun Sao. It doesn't, you know, and you see him work it so fast. It doesn't work that way. That's all choreographed. You have to adapt, and you have to be quick. You got to be accurate. The other thing that I noticed is that the Tai Chi guy probably has not sparred, if not ever, in a long time. So therefore, him taking a hit, okay, across the face or in the chest, in your stomach, or in your head, he probably didn't know how to respond to that type of stimulus. Yes, it's gonna hurt. The guy's not there to give you love taps. I mean, he's there to hurt you, so you have to respond. If you don't know how to take a hit, then you're gonna be in trouble. One of the most important things in my American Kempo class that the head instructor tells us is spar, and spar some more. Why? Because on the streets, when you get hit, especially in the stomach or in the face, you're going to need to know how to remain calm under pressure, know how to react to that type of stimulus, so that way you can go home, so you can be able to walk home on your two feet rather than be carried away in an ambulance. So we spar weekly, and we spar constantly. And you know, we're not having cage matches to destroy each other, but to learn, to adapt to our opponent, to understand what is it that our opponent is doing that is causing us to get hit, and what is it that we need to do in order to go to our opponent and to hit them, okay? Because if you don't spar, how are you going to know how you're going to react to getting hit or to actually hitting somebody? It's bad that the guy lost the way he did. In his mind, he was probably thinking, I'll do my Tai Chi stuff and it will just work and I don't have to worry about it. But the result is quite obvious. It is. And this leads me to several quotes by Sun Tzu, the author of The Art of War, where he said that in war, to win, you must know your enemy and you must know yourself. He also said that if you know the enemy and you know yourself, then in 100 battles, you need not worry or fear defeat. But if you not know your enemy, and you only know yourself, then in 100 battles, you will see 50 victories, and you will see 50 defeats. And if you not know the enemy, and not also yourself, then in 100 battles, you will see nothing but defeat. That's Sun Tzu. And I take his words very, very prophetically and carefully. You must understand who you're fighting, what is it that you're fighting, the concepts behind it, and adaptation. You must adapt. One of the things that Wing Chun and the Art of War have in common is that they stress adaptability. If you don't adapt to your opponent, you're going to fail and you're going to lose. So that being said, take a look at the video. Let me know what you think. It like I said, it's the guy. The fight lasts 15 seconds, and he just got railroaded, the Tai Chi Master. Again, happy Mother's Day to all the mommies out there. And that's it. Toodaloo, guys. Peace. Until the next video.